Hello guys, what is up? It's your boy Novanity Reacts, back again with another reaction. Today we're taking a look at Marvel's What If, and this What If is if Peggy Carter becomes the first Avenger, so it's going to be pretty interesting to see this play out and everything like that. If you guys are interested in my Marvel reactions and everything like that, take a look at my Marvel trailer reaction for Venom, and also I reacted to WandaVision, Loki, and also Falcon and Winter Soldier. All those playlists are over on my channel. Also, if you guys want to see the full length of this What If or any of the Marvel content on my channel, make sure you guys check out my Patreon, link is down below in the description, and you guys can check out full lengths there. Other than that, let's get started, shall we? Creating alternate worlds from the ones you know. Yo, this is dope already. Huh. I am the Watcher. I am your guide through these vast new realities. I know. What if? It's amazing. I wonder if this series is just taking a trip through all the alternate realities that Loki and Sylvie created, essentially. Well, mostly Sylvie. 1943. The Nazi army marches across Europe, leaving death and destruction. The Allied armies band together to create a new kind of soldier, a super soldier. At humanity's darkest hour, a skinny kid from Brooklyn became Captain America. After turning the tide of World War II, he made the ultimate sacrifice, restoring peace and saving this universe. But in another universe, a single choice created a whole new hero. Peggy Carter chose to stay, but soon it would be her venturing into the unknown and creating a new world.
I'm the buttons guy. Stark, get over there. Tech and bullets don't mix. We're gonna lose everything. It has to be now.
Do you know how much this costs?
We won't get another shot at this.
Hang on. I'll be right back.
I'm not going anywhere.
Howard, get ready.
Agent Carter.
What are you doing?
This is gonna be really interesting.
Agent Carter, what are you doing?
This is our only chance. Now!
Stark, don't do this.
This is interesting because this is like back in the day where I think women weren't really in the army, I think. I could be wrong. So that's maybe why he's like, why you do this? Stop doing it. Damn, bro. She looks like the She-Hulk.
Did it work?
And then some. You won't be needing those heels anymore.
Peggy? Wow.
I'd call this an absolute success.
What an absolute failure. $60 million and all the hope in the world down the drain. I was promised an army. I was promised peace and salvation. Instead, I get a girl.
I understand this is not the desired outcome, but I can be more than a human pinky.
You. And if we get lucky, someday your blood might tell us how to make a real super soldier.
You have a super soldier.
Women aren't soldiers. They sure as
hell
fight on the front lines.
Oh, damn. Show him different, Peggy.
I'm sorry. You were meant to be the one to end the war.
Now you will. And don't worry about me. I never was much of a dancer anyway.
Maybe you haven't found the right partner.
I'm trying to think of the first Captain America movie. Did something explode in a room when Steve was in there? I can't remember. There's so many movies.
But we have a chance. If we send a team tonight, we can get our hands...
You're out of your mind, Stark.
I could go.
Great, now you're both crazy. Fantastic. Now I have two crazy people running around the place.
20, 30 men max? If this reaches Hydra High Command, it's game over.
I'm not risking one man, never mind a platoon, over a glorified battery.
The greatest minds alive...
And Stark is one of them.
This doesn't concern you. You're lucky to be in the room.
Colonel, the greatest minds
alive... Come on, bro.
...fathom the extent of this battery's power.
Good. Who knows? Maybe the war will be over before Hydra figures out how to turn the damn thing on.
What's this?
It was supposed to be your USO Let's Go Sell Some War Bonds costume, but I made a few upgrades.
Your covert skills need work.
Then this is gonna be awkward.
That's interesting. Everything's different, for sure. Damn. How tall was that building? Run her down, really? Okay. Yo. That's cool as hell.
Damn.
She's like, oh, I can do that? That's death. Death for sure. I'm seeing it for sure. You're just killing the people. That was such... Oh, that's death again? Yo, that's so much death. Which is fine. I feel like that would just like break their skulls and stuff. What the heck? Getting hit with vibranium.
You being my life.
The allies must be desperate. Sending in a fragile Fraulein to fight for them.
Fragile.
Yo. I don't understand what you mean by fragile. She just took out like 50 people.
Exactly.
You could be like, oh, you're not that strong.
The war's out there, Colonel, not in here. If we're going to win, it won't be with me stuck behind a desk.
Need all the friends we can get.
I owe you one.
You owe me more than that. You owe me a dance.
She still likes Steve. That's good.
This is nice. You mind if I have a go?
What the heck? I would love this as a like a live action. This would be pretty cool to see Peggy like this. Or because of the branching realities and stuff, she somehow comes in. I would be all for it. For sure. If for some reason she just came from a different reality.
Fight like that. Since today. Understood.
Are you the 107th? I'm here for Sergeant Barnes.
Who are you supposed to be? Queen of England?
Steve Rogers sent me. The name's Captain Carter.
I'm confused now. Wouldn't they have already met her? Because of the training, like Steve going over the grenade and everything like that.
Rogers, inbound.
Steve?
Rogers?
Powered by the Tesseract?
Hey, Peggy. Now you owe me one.
Friends with that Hydra Stomper?
I think I'm friends with him, too.
He became, like, Iron Man? What the heck?
Stark made me some new dancing shoes.
So you became kind of like, Rhodey a little bit. Because I guess Steve can't walk or whatever. Rhodey needs a machine to walk. Dad made an Iron Man, bro. That's crazy. That's crazy. They never had the Tesseract first. That's the thing. Hydra always had it till the very end. This is so different. Yo, Peggy's doing some work, bro. Deaf? Potentially? That's insane. Yo, I need that scene. Either Steve doing it in the original. Obviously not. I need that in live action. That scene right there. That looks amazing.
You're my hero, Steve. I mean, you're a hero.
It's so weird how they made Steve. He looks 40. Barnstormer Jeep. What the heck?
The very head of Hydra is on that train.
We can end the war? Yeah, I've heard that one before.
Oh, what if it's Steve that becomes Winter Soldier, bro?
Thanks. You almost ripped my arm off.
Ironic.
Peggy, go! Get out of here!
No way. Maybe the Tesseract saved them because it's kind of like a sentient being.
You're wasting your time. I will tell you nothing.
He told me everything.
Yo, she's badass. Just saying. The way she moves and everything. 10 out of 10.
Huh. Too late, Captain Carter. I have summoned the champion of
Hydra. 100%. Yo, some Wonder Woman type stuff? Don't get sucked up, Steve.
Steve Rogers.
The war ended.
Yo, that's insane because Loki comes out that portal. What the heck?
You're going to be okay.
Her one choice gave birth to a whole new history and gave the multiverse a new hero. As for me, these are my stories. I observe all that transpires here, but I do not.
So no Winter Soldier. That's interesting.
Will not interfere.
Okay guys, so that was my reaction for Marvel's What If, Season 1, Episode 1, if Peggy Carter became the first Avenger, which is pretty interesting how it all played out. The only thing that was a little bit confusing to me was the fact that Bucky and them didn't recognize Carter, because in the beginning of Captain America First Avenger, they were all trading with Peggy Carter, you know? So by Peggy Carter going in there, it was kind of confusing to see them say, oh, who are you? You know what you mean? You know what I mean? I would thought they would know because she was in the training with Steve and everything, becoming the first soldier. Just everything like that. I would have thought they would know who Peggy Carter is because of that. But they were acting like they didn't know her at all. So that's pretty interesting, unless that did not happen at all. I'm confused. But it did seem like she does know Steve and everything by that time, so makes me believe those events did happen, that did happen in the first Avenger and everything, like leading up until the super serum happened. So it's pretty confusing to me how that worked out and everything like that. I'm pretty confused about the whole bomb thing in there. I did not know there was a bomb. I thought he just shot the doctor. Maybe there was a bomb and I'm just tripping. And I thought Carter was there too, because Steve came out the thing. I thought Carter was there. I don't know. There's a lot of things that's confused me now. I might have to rewatch that movie again. Maybe one of you guys in the comment section can tell me what really happened in the first Avenger versus this one. And maybe I don't have to watch it because I'm pretty lazy. But I'm probably going to watch it anyway. Watch that one scene and see how it's different from this scene. Because there's a lot of things that's I think happened, but maybe I'm just totally wrong. But overall, this first episode was amazing. I wish they actually had like maybe 2-3 episodes out for this first one, for this first series or whatever season, maybe episode 2 or something. But I enjoyed it. I really like the fact that Peggy gave up her life in the way she did, and everything like that. And Steve is probably just old man Steve, which is interesting to see and everything like that. So I'm guessing there's no Winter Soldier first thought, I thought when Steve, you know, left, I thought he was going to be a Winter Soldier kind of character. I mean, it's still possible that he is a Winter Soldier character. I can't leave anything undone because Hydra is probably still doing its experiments on super soldier people, even though the Red Skull is gone and everything like that. Everything is the same. So leading up to this point, they probably are still testing on people, everything, to become super soldiers and everything like that in the Marvel universe, or in this parallel universe for sure. And I'm just wondering how Tony is doing in this universe for sure, because obviously Howard is his dad and everything. So it's pretty interesting to see that happening and everything like that. Hopefully, if there is a season 2, maybe we get something more explored with this, or during the season, maybe a part 2 to this, because I would like to see how Peggy reacts to old man Steve, or vice versa for sure. But anyway, if you guys want to see the full length, it'll be over on my Patreon. Link is down below in the description. Other than that, thank you guys so much for the support. It's really, really appreciated. I'll see you guys later. Another Marvel's What If. Peace. Bye.